Praise the Lord. I'm grateful to God for this opportunity that He has given to us, that we can meet together through this moment of sharing the Word of God. He's the one who provides chance, opportunities, who opens doors, even to be able to reach one another in this moment. So I welcome you to this program of sharing the Word of God. I welcome you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We'll begin with a short word of prayer. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you that you have given us a chance, O God, when we can fellowship together over your word. We thank you, O God, that your presence is with us. Lord, I pray that your Holy Spirit will rest upon my life and rest upon the viewer, the listener, and that all of us together shall receive of you, and that your name will be glorified. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Yes, my name is Sakai Veno. I love the Lord. And I'm going to share with us the Word of God from the book of Matthew chapter 24. And I was to read a few verses from there in Jesus' name. Amen. I want to read from verse 4. It says, And Jesus answered and said unto them, Take heed that no man deceive you, for many shall come in my name, saying, I am Christ, and shall deceive many. And you shall hear wars and rumors of wars. See that you be not troubled, for all these things must come to pass, but the end is not yet. For nation shall rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. And there shall be famines and pestilences, and earthquakes in diverse places. All these are the beginning of sorrows. Then shall they deliver you up to be afflicted, and shall kill you, and you shall be hated of all nations for my name's sake. Let us stop there for the time being, in Jesus' name. Amen. The Lord Jesus, in this passage, was speaking to the disciples about the end times, about the characteristics of the end time, the signs of the last days before the end of the age, before the end of the church age. He was speaking to them because they had asked Jesus, what will be the sign of your coming? What will be the signs of these things happening? And Jesus was responding to that question that his disciples had asked him about the end times. And I thought it's good to just mention something, few things about the end times, even as we share the Word of God. You will remember that last time in our last program, we were sharing from the book of Joel, chapter 2. And in that prophecy of Joel, we saw that the prophet Joel was seeing the days that were coming, that were coming upon the land. And we saw that there were days that would be very gloomy, days of darkness, and days that would be really terrible and unbearable as far as the strength of man is concerned. And Joel was seeing in the spirit, was seeing how destruction will come upon the land, how the locusts will destroy the caterpillar, the palmerworm, the cankerworm, how they would devour the land to the extent there was no more fruit and the land would become desolate. And so in that circumstance, he began to call upon the people, call upon the priests to begin to cry, to lament, to lift a cry unto the Lord because of the situation, because of the way things were going to be, because of the terrible things that were coming. And we saw in that sharing how the prophet Joel was calling on everybody, including the farmers. And we saw that the priests in particular was to lead the way in crying. And he said, let the priests, let the ministers of the Lord come and mourn. And even himself, Prophet Joel, as we saw, he began to cry himself. And he said, oh Lord, I lift a cry unto you. And mainly they were crying out for mercy. And we went on further to see in chapter 2 how God was speaking through Prophet Joel to tell the people that even now, even at that time, they would turn to God. They would turn to God with all their heart, with weeping, with mourning, with lamentation, and renting their hearts unto the Lord. And the Lord was saying that when Israel, on one hand, God's people would do so, because he is gracious and he is merciful, he is slow to anger, and he relents of evil, he would turn away from the judgment, and instead he would give a blessing. I thought to give you just a reminder, a recap of what we share, because it is related in a sense, and it's a continuation to what we are sharing even today. In Jesus' name. It involved everybody, as you remember, the priests, the ministers, the children, the elders, all the congregation of the Lord were together. They were to assemble themselves, and all of them with one mind, with one voice, they would lift a cry to God, asking for mercy, asking God to spare his people, to spare his heritage, that the heathen or the nations would not ask, where is their God? And we saw that God was going to respond when God's people would turn to him. And he would respond by showing them mercy. And the Bible said that he will be jealous over the land, and he will pity, he will have mercy on his people. And it is a similar thing that God would have us to do even at a time like this, when nations are going through turmoil. So back to the passage we have just read in Matthew chapter 24. So the Lord was saying that this, among the signs of the end times, was that there would be wars and rumors of wars all over the world, all over the earth. And there would be so much trouble all over the world. And nation would rise against nation, kingdom against kingdom. There would be earthquakes in diverse places, in various places. There would be famines, drought, and there would be pestilences. I was just thinking about that word, pestilences. And it has something linked to even what the world is going through right now. Pestilences are kind of pests and diseases. Diseases that are incurable, and all kinds of sickness, all those form pestilences. And the Lord said that such things would happen. There would be pestilences in the earth in the last days. And he was saying that this would be the beginning of sorrows, the beginning of the pains that were marking, that would mark the end times, the last days. And so I thought that it's necessary to remind ourselves that such things are happening because we are in the last days. Such things are happening because we are in the end times. And we need to do what the Lord asks us to do. And one of the things that we see in the scripture here is the Lord speaking to his disciples. He says that be not troubled. Our hearts as human beings have a tendency to be troubled when we go through hard circumstances, difficult situations. I think we also remember what Jesus said to the disciples again in John 14, verse 1. He says, when he was speaking to them about he was now approaching to go to the cross, and then he would ascend back to the Father, and the disciples began to be fearful. They began to be worried that Jesus was going to leave them. But the Lord said to them, be not troubled. Do not let your hearts be troubled. So he's saying the same about how we are to react in these difficult days of the end times, that we be not troubled. We be not fearful. We be not terrified. We be not shaken. The book of Luke, a verse which I may refer to quite often, is said in the book of Luke that instead of being terrified, instead of being fearful, we are to look up, to the Lord. We are to look up, we are to lift our heads, to look up, because it is from there that our help cometh from. Look up to heaven, look up to the throne of grace, from where we can find help, because we cannot find help anywhere around us in difficult circumstances. Our help cometh from the Lord, who is the maker of heaven and earth. So I'm here to encourage you in the name of Jesus that you look up in a time like this. Look up in prayer, look up unto the Lord, because that is where our help will come from. All these things, they're shakings in a sense. The Lord said in his word that he will shake the heavens and he will shake the earth. In Hebrews chapter 12 tells us there'll be shakings, and they're meant to shake us, and so that everything that is shakeable, everything that can be shaken in our lives and in the world, we would put away those things. And instead, we hold on to what cannot be shaken, what cannot be removed, what can withstand, what is able to withstand. We cling to what is able to withstand. Praise the Lord. And so when we go through such situations, trials, when we go through tribulations, troublous times, perilous times, there are shakings, and we begin to see ourselves. We begin to know how much strength we really have. In another sense, we are like students who are going to do an examination, or we are like athletes who have been doing a lot of practice, and now the time for competition comes. You see, before the actual exam comes, before the actual day of the event comes, everyone can say they are mighty, they are strong, they are able. But the real strength will be tested, or the real ability to be able to withstand will be tested when the actual testing comes. So shakings come to show us how strong we are, and how much we need to depend upon the Lord. Praise the Lord. And so, in this passage of the end times, Jesus spoke to about it in Matthew, in Mark, in the Gospel of Luke as well. And he said that there would be the beginning of sorrows. There would be beginning of times of pain, times that are painful. In 2 Timothy, it is described as perilous times, times that are difficult to deal with or to bear, times that are beyond the strength of man, times that we cannot lean on our own strength. So in such circumstances, we learn to look up instead of looking upon our own strength or depending upon our own strength. We rather look unto God. Praise the Lord. Amen. Only The foundation that has been laid by God is the foundation that is sure. The same book of 2 Timothy says, nevertheless, the foundation of God standeth sure. The foundation that is laid by God, the foundation that God himself has laid, the foundation that God himself has built, that is a foundation that is sure. That is a foundation that is unshakable. That is a foundation that we are to stand on. Praise God. And Jesus, when he was teaching also the disciples, he said, I will show you what a man who hears my word and does it or obeys my word, I will liken him to a man who dug deep. He dug out the sand, he dug out the soil, he dug out everything that was porous. And then finally he got to a rock, and there he laid the foundation of his house. And he said, that kind of foundation is a foundation that will withstand the winds. Winds like we are going through now all over the world. The winds of trouble, winds of pestilences, of disease that has no cure. The winds, storms, the floods, floods of trouble, floods of all kinds. And he said that house, which is built upon a rock, whose foundation is on a rock, whose foundation is on the word of God, that foundation is a sure foundation. So shakings like this, they show us where we are weak, where we are still leaning on ourselves, where we are still depending on something else, so that we would remove those things and instead we seek the foundation that God himself has laid. Praise the Lord. So I'm encouraging you, I'm encouraging myself in the name of the Lord not to be shaken. Just as the Lord said, do not be terrified, be not troubled. Don't allow your hearts to be troubled, to be terrified, to be fearful, to be sorrowful. He said, instead, lift up your heads and look up, because your redemption draweth nigh. Your salvation, the day of being taken home, the day draweth nigh, the day of the coming of the Lord to come for his bride, to come for the church, to come for the ready church, the day is drawing nigh. That is drawing closer. Praise the Lord. Amen. So I'm that is my purpose of sharing with you when we are going through plagues, when we are going through pestilences, when we are facing troublous times that man cannot cope with, man cannot bear. The wisdom of man is not able to give a solution. We have to lean on God. We have to depend on the Lord. Praise the Lord. And we lean on his promises that he made to us in the word. He said that he will be with us to the end of the age, to the end of the world. He will be with us. He will be with us right up to the end. So we cling to the promise of the Lord that he is with us, even at a time like this. In another way also, still sharing right from the word of God, because that is where we find answers. That is where we can search through and find God speak to us. It's that very famous Psalm, Psalm 23, which I believe you have learned it from the early days of your life. When it begins, it says, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Like those two, three verses that begin, it's like everything is well. The Lord is my shepherd. I'm in green pastures. I'm still waters. That is one aspect in which the Lord deals with our lives, in which everything around us is beautiful, is pasture, is still waters, peaceful all around. It's one aspect in which we see the goodness of the Lord shepherding our lives, watching over our lives. But at some point, he begins to take us to another place. He says, though I go through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. That is like another setting altogether, where the psalmist, where David is going through a valley of the shadow of death. That is a troublous time. Valley is not a place of joy. It's not a mountain top. It's not a place like it is pleasant. You're hidden. You're like in a, you see, look this side, you look this side, you look this side, all over. It's like darkness. It's like a rock. You're not seeing anything like good around in the valley. Nothing appears to be good. It's like the kind of setting we are in right now, in these perilous times. You look around, people fear one another, even to shake hands. If someone just sneezes, you feel like running away from them. Nothing seems to be good around. The news we receive on television, on social media, everything is scary around us. It's a valley. It's like a valley of the shadow of death. It's where we see nothing good around us. But that is when you can lift up your eyes, where you can look up. You can look up and you can see the Lord. That is the place where you can hold on to the promise of the Lord, where it says, it shall be with us. And you'll be with us even in that valley. His presence is with us, even in that valley of the shadow of death. And his rod and his staff, they comfort us. So even the comfort of the Lord is with us at a time like this. And I'm praying that that comfort of the Lord, that encouragement, that assurance of the Lord will reach you right where you are in this time, so that you can be encouraged in your heart. You can be strong in faith, like the Bible says. Be strong in faith. Be like men, not men out of your own ability or out of human ability. Not man in the sense of depending on himself, but man in the sense of depending on God. A man who is strong in the Lord, strong in the power of his might, strong to stand up in a time like this, so that you may not only be strong in yourself, strong for yourself, but strong for the sake of somebody else. Strong so that you can strengthen another person. Praise the Lord. I will to conclude by giving us the example of Peter, the disciple of Jesus. When Jesus was about to go to the cross, when Jesus was about to be crucified, and we know what happened with Peter. Everybody among the disciples, when the Lord told them how it will be, how they would run away and forsake him, and everyone was saying, I will not forsake you, Lord. Even if everybody else, including Peter, said, even if everybody else leaves you, forsakes you, I will not leave you. And the Lord said to him, by before the cock crows, you will have denied me three times. And Peter could not see how he could deny the Lord. You see, the time of testing came, the time that was perilous, the time that was very troublesome for Peter and for all the other disciples. It came. It came when Jesus was arrested, and surely was tested for what his strength was. And he was found to be wanting. He denied the Lord three times, as we know. Even when a little girl was asking him, surely you are one of him. You are one of them. Surely you are one of them. Even your tongue just betrays you. And he denied the Lord, even to the point of swearing. And so his strength was found to be weak. His ability was found to be weak in a day of test, in a day of shake. Praise God. But we remember something there before Peter went into that test. There is a prayer the Lord made for him. Luke chapter 22. The Lord looked at Peter and he said, Peter, Satan has desired to sift you like wheat, to shake you like wheat, to shake you like wheat. Satan has desired to sift you like wheat. But the Lord said, but I prayed for you. I prayed for you. The Lord is even at this time is interceding for us in heaven. Thank God we have an intercessor in heaven. We have an intercessor within us, the Holy Spirit. Praise the Lord. And the Lord said, I have prayed for you that your faith will not fail, that your faith will not altogether crumble, but that your faith will remain. You see, this, the Bible says that the just shall live by faith. The just shall stand by faith. The just shall overcome by faith. The believer will stand by faith. So our faith needs to be strong at this time so that we can help our nation, help nations, help each other, help our neighbors. Our faith needs to be strong. So I'm sharing with us this message. Do not be troubled. Do not be fearful. Do not be terrified. Instead, let your faith be strong in the Lord. Let your strength be in the Lord. May the Lord strengthen you. Praise God. Amen. Amen. Sometimes we don't even know how to pray at a time like this. And the ways in which we can pray, the ways in which we can learn to pray. One of them, which is so important, is to pray in the Spirit. To pray in the Spirit. It's so important for a believer to be filled with the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit, that means the Holy Spirit indwelling us. The Holy Spirit, like we are baptized, we are submerged in Him. We are immersed in Him. We are immersed in the Holy Spirit. Baptized, just like somebody is baptized in much water. The same way we are baptized in the Holy Spirit. And when we are baptized that way, when we are filled in the Holy Spirit, we are able to pray in a heavenly tongue. A communication where we ourselves cannot understand. The Bible says we are speaking secrets unto God. We are speaking things that are mysteries to us. And the Holy Spirit at that moment is praying on our behalf, is groaning on our behalf in a way that we ourselves cannot understand, but He understands what we are going through. He understands our state, and He's able to make prayer on our behalf. So at a time like this, it's so important to pray in the Spirit, to pray in the Spirit, because we don't know everything. We don't know what's coming tomorrow. We don't know how the situation is. We can only stay in hope and prayer. Praise the Lord. Amen. So that is my encouragement to you in Jesus' name. The Lord prayed for Peter that his faith would not fail. And there's something more that the Lord said. He said, when you are restored, that is when Peter would be restored after denying the Lord, and then he would be filled with the Holy Spirit. When he would be restored, when he's restored, the Lord said that he would strengthen his brethren. That's why I'm saying you need to be strong, not only for yourself, not only for your family, but for somebody else, for the nation, for nations of the world. You need to be strong in the Lord. You need to be strong in faith, so that you can be a blessing. Praise the Lord. Amen. That's my encouragement in the name of Jesus Christ. And I would like to pray with us. We will continue in the next program in Jesus' name. So I decide to pray together with us at this moment, to pray for you, to pray for you that your faith will be strong. My faith will be strong. our faith together will even be stronger. Yours and mine combined will be stronger. Will be stronger, and we can be able to look to God for an answer, to look to God in these perilous times to save us, to deliver us in the name of Jesus. One of the other ways in which I will also include it in the prayers we pray is, I never thought of this, I've not prayed it for a long time. I don't remember the last time. Is in that pattern prayer that the Lord taught the disciples, that we sometimes call the Lord's Prayer. There is an aspect at the end where the Lord said in that prayer, he said, prayed and said, this is how we should pray. Lead us not into temptation. Lead us not into trouble. Lead us not into perilous times. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. I felt like that is also another way, appropriate way in which we can pray. Lord, lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us from this evil that has come over nations. Deliver us from this pestilence, O God. Have mercy on us in the name of Jesus. That is another third way to pray. I've said pray in the Spirit. I've said pray the word. Pray the way the Lord taught us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Another third way is we can ask God for mercy. When we don't know how to pray, ask the Lord, Lord, show mercy. Lord, have mercy on us. Have mercy on our nation. Have mercy on nations, Lord, because God is gracious, is merciful. So I'm going to conclude in prayer in Jesus' name. Shall we pray together? But just bow your head right where you are. Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name, I want to thank you for this program, this time we've had of sharing your word, oh God, of encouraging each other and seeing what the word of God says about these times. I want to thank you, our Father, that in sharing your word, Lord, you are able to strengthen us, you feed us. And so I pray for my faith as I pray for the faith of the listener, the viewer, that our faith, oh God, will not fail. In these trying times of pestilences, sicknesses, diseases that are incurable, that are all over the world, and there appears to be nowhere to run to, and a man is overwhelmed, we lift our eyes unto you, Lord, as you told us to do. We look up unto you, Father, that our help will come from you, from above, from heaven. We pray that you will send us help from your sanctuary. Send help to the viewer right now, to the listener, O God. Send help, O Father, to your church. Send help, our Father, to our nation and to the nations of the world. Send help, our Father, that our faith will not fail, but instead we will be strengthened, O God, in the name of Jesus. And so we look unto you, our Father. We pray, our God, that you come down to strengthen us in the mighty name of Jesus. I thank you, Lord, and I'm giving you praise and adoration and glory. Thank you, Almighty Father. Thank you, King of Glory. We give you praise, honor, and adoration. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Maybe also you are there, you are a viewer, you have just come across this message as you went through and your searching for what to see, what to listen to, and maybe you came across this and probably you don't know the Lord Jesus as your personal Savior. You don't have a personal relationship with him. I want to pray with you in Jesus' name that you would give your life to the Lord Jesus Christ. And if you're there, just say this short prayer of repentance together with me. Say, Lord Jesus, I thank you that you loved me. You came down from heaven to seek me out, to find me, to save me. You shed your blood. You laid down your life that I may be saved. Today I come to you. I ask you, Lord, that you forgive me all my sin. Wash me with your precious blood. I receive you into my heart, Lord Jesus, to be my Lord and Savior. Thank you for saving my soul. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. So if you repeated that prayer from your heart, I want to assure you that you're born again. That is what the Bible tells us. As many as received him, as many as received the Lord Jesus, they are given the power, the right to become children of God. So you're a child of God. I'm praying, God, that he will lead you to a church nearby where the word of God is taught, where the minister is sharing the word out of the power of the Holy Spirit, that you may grow among other believers. So God bless you. Thank you so much for tuning into this program. May God bless you. Until we meet in the next program, in Jesus' name we pray.